Hello, and welcome, everyone. Thank you for joining me today for this talk. My name is Sukhpreet Bedi. I'm a Database Specialist Solutions Architect with AWS, focusing on Amazon RDS and Amazon Aurora for PostgreSQL Database Engine. Today, in this session, we will talk about how you can get started with using PLRust and write high-performance Rust code directly into your Amazon RDS databases. Let's get started. To set a little bit of background, let's talk about what are stored procedures or functions in PostgreSQL. PostgreSQL allows users to extend the database functionality with the help of user-defined functions and stored procedures. The stored procedures are blocks of SQL statements or a code that performs some task. These can help you build powerful and scalable database applications that can perform complex calculations on your data. These functions are very convenient to the developers because once the function is compiled, the code can be reused over and over again. You can write these procedures or functions in various languages like the standard SQL or PLPG SQL. The standard edition of PostgreSQL supports four procedural languages, which are PLPG SQL, TCL, Perl, and Python. But then there are additional procedural languages available, like Rust and JavaScript, that are not included in the code distribution, but can be loaded using the extensions. PostgreSQL also has this concept of trusted and untrusted languages, and a trusted language is the one that is safe for an underprivileged user to use without the risk of privilege escalation. Recently, we announced the support for the Rust programming language with Amazon RDS for PostgreSQL. Using Rust, you can build high-performance user-defined functions and run them directly inside your PostgreSQL databases. So why PLRust? PLRust is a trusted procedural language that has significant performance benefits over a stored procedural language like PLPG SQL. The performance of the code written in Rust language is comparable to writing in C without the risk of unsafe memory access. PLRust also supports various built-in functions like triggers and the features like logging output in PostgreSQL log files. Rust is an energy-efficient language, and it can help you achieve your organization's sustainability goals. Based on a study done a few years ago, Rust is about 50% more efficient than Java and about 98% more efficient than Python. PLRust is an open source language and it is available on all database instances in Amazon RDS running PostgreSQL version 15.2 and higher. Next, let's see how do you get started with PLRust on Amazon RDS. Enabling PLRust on Amazon RDS involves two steps. All you have to do is add the PLRust value to the shared preload parameter in your database parameter group and restart your database instance to bring this parameter in effect. You can make this change using AWS console or the AWS CLI commands. And after the restart, you can use the simple create extension command to install the PLRust in your database. Next, let's take a quick look at Trusted Language Extension, that is another open source project to build the extensions. Trusted Language Extension is an open source project for building high performance and safe PostgreSQL extensions. There are a lot of challenges when it comes to installing a new extension in your PostgreSQL database. You need access to the file system underneath to install an extension, or an extension you want to use may not be available with a managed service. And the PostgreSQL major version upgrades, they can be very difficult and you might need to upgrade your extensions to work with a new major version. So supporting new extension is a time-consuming task because we want to make sure that an extension is safe to run in your database. That's where trusted language extensions can help you. With TLE, developers can use one of the popular trusted language like PLPG SQL, JavaScript, or Rust to write an extension and safely run them in your database. DLE is designed to prevent access to the unsafe resources. Additionally, your DBAs have full control on who can install the extensions, and it provides a permission model for running those extensions that you create. How does DLE work and how do you create the extensions? To create a trusted language extension, you write a code in one of the trusted language, for example, PLRust, and package that Rust code in the DLE framework to build an extension definition. You can then use an install function to install the extension in your database and use familiar commands like create extension to create and start using it. You also have an option to create a new version of an extension as you collect the feedback and want to update them. Enabling DLE on Amazon RDS is very similar to how you enable PLRust. You add the extension pgdle in pre-shareload libraries parameter and then restart your database. Following the restart, you create the extension in your database and begin using DLE. And once you have the pgdle installed in your database, you get access to various functions to create and manage your extensions. You can use these functions to install, register, update, and manage your DLE extensions that you developed using this development kit. Next, let's look at a quick demo on how you can start building with PLRust on Amazon RDS. In this demo, we start with enabling the extensions pgdle and PLRust. Then we'll create a simple trusted language extension using the Rust code. We'll use the DLE functions to update and create a new version of extension. And we will also see how you can log messages and errors directly from your Rust functions in your PostgreSQL log files. I have the pgdle demo database instance, which is the RDS PostgreSQL 15.2 version. I go to the configuration tab here and I'll open the DB instance parameter group and make changes to the shared preload libraries parameter. So we'll add pgdle and PLRust value to this and modify the changes. So my database is modifying and applying those changes, and once the instance is available, if we go back and look into the configuration settings, we'll see that the status changes to pending reboot. We'll have to reboot our database instance to bring these parameters into effect. Okay, now that my instance is available, I'll go back, I'll switch to my terminal and we'll go ahead and start creating our first extension. So I'm connecting to the database and the first step would be to verify if we have the pgdle and PLRust loaded in our libraries. We do have the extensions available, but we will still have to go ahead and create the extensions using create extension keyword. So we create pgdle and we also create the PLRust extension. Now that we have created pgdle and PLRust, we do have access to all the functions that come as part of this DLE project. And you know, let's go ahead and create our first extension. So I have this I'm using this function called install extension, using which I'm creating the function called number of planets. It's going to check the number of planets using this particular function definition. I'm using PLRust as the language, and the expected value is 8, and the actual value is 9. And the logic is that if the expected value is not equal to the actual value, it's going to error out and display this error message to me. But if the values are equal, it will log that message into the PostgreSQL log files. So we create this first extension and we go back and look into our list of installed extensions, and we'll see that, you know, the extension is available in the database, but it is not installed. So that is because we still haven't actually created the extension. We have to go back and create extension using the familiar commands like create extension. Now that we have created the extension, let's go and run our function here. So when we run this function, it displays the error message incorrect value for the number of planets. So it runs as expected, right? So let's go ahead and create another version of this extension using another PGTLE function, right? So we have this function called install update path, which I'm going to use to create a new version of my extension and a different definition here. I'm updating the definition, and this time I'm using expected value is equal to 8, and the actual value is also 8. So this should not error out this time, but instead it should log the message in the PostgreSQL log file. So let's go ahead and create this extension. Now we see the list of available extension versions. We see we have two different versions of extensions here, right? And we set the default version as the 0.2, which is the newest version that we just created. Right. So this is the default extension, but again, we have to go, we have to do the author extension to update. Now that we have updated our extension, if we verify in the list of installed extensions, we see the number of planets. It's using the version 0.2, which is the newest version. So if we run this function again, this time it doesn't error out, but instead it displays the message in the PostgreSQL log file. So the number of planets, it's returning 8. And this log message, if we go back to our RDS instance into the logs, we look at the latest log file. So the log file will see it's logging all of these messages here. I see the error. I see the log message as well, where it's displaying the number of planets as 8. All right. So this concludes my demo. To summarize the session, PLRust enables you to build high-performance, user-defined functions using the Rust code and wrap them up into an extension using Trusted Language Extensions Framework. Thank you, everyone, for joining me today for this session. I'm super excited to see the awesome extensions you will build using PLRust and TLE. Have a great day.